morning, everybody. I hope, can you hear me well? Thank you. I will be taking the whole service on the altar, because we are recording and streaming this and going live on Facebook for those who are unable to join us this morning. It's great to be back with you. It's wonderful to be together, although it does seem a little strange, doesn't it, wearing these masks. I realise this can feel a little claustrophobic, so if during the service you feel you need to go outside, just remove them for a moment or two. Please do just indicate to the side people, and they will direct you out accordingly. There'll be a few things that are a little different this morning. There'll be a shorter service. There'll be some parts of the service missing that you might have been expecting. When it comes to the reception of communion, please remain in your pews until you're invited forward by the side person. I will then give you communion in host only at the step. There are various points at which you'll be asked to sanitize your hands. Please follow the directions of the side people. And as you receive communion, you return to the seat. You'll go behind the organ. Please do mind the step there. There is a sign. But it's wonderful to have you with us this morning. During the lockdown, the church has not been closed. The buildings have, but we have still been very busy. Hopefully we've seen some of the services that have been taking place from my dining room that has become the group chapel. And in that was part of the whole Easter liturgy took place, and you should hopefully receive your palm crossing. And this morning we say a few words from the Easter liturgy, and we light the Easter candle. And actually, I just realised I don't have a taper with me. Jonathan, could you bring me the taper out of the vestry, please? The taper out of the vestry, please. Christ, yesterday and today, the beginning and the end, Alpha and Omega. All time belongs to Him and all ages. To Him be glory and power to every age and forever. And so we light the Easter candle, Paschal candle. May the light of Christ rising in glory banish all darkness from our hearts and minds. Hallelujah! Christ is risen. Everlasting God, we give you thanks that our Lord Jesus Christ was raised gloriously from the dead, crushing the power of sin and destroying the sting of death. May we and all Christ's people shine as lights in the world to the glory of God the Father. Amen. We meet in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
We join together in the prayers of penitence. Lord, you are gracious and compassionate. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You are loving to all, and your mercy is over all your creation. Christ, have mercy. Your faithful servants bless your name and speak the glory of your kingdom. Lord, have mercy. Almighty God, who forgives all who truly repent, have mercy upon you. Pardon and deliver you from all your sins. Confirm and strengthen you in all goodness and keep you in life eternal through Jesus Christ our Lord. And the collect for today, the 8th Sunday after Trinity. Almighty Lord and everlasting God, we beseech you to direct, sanctify, and govern both our hearts and bodies in the way of your laws and the works of your commandments, that through your most mighty protection, both here and ever after, we may be preserved in body and soul through our Lord and Saviour Jesus Christ, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
And a special prayer for today, for our first service post-lockdown. that all who seek you in this place may find you, and they be filled with the Holy Spirit, that they may become the living temple acceptable to you, through Jesus Christ, your Son, our Lord, who is alive and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever.
Amen.
We now have our first reading.
The reading is taken from Romans chapter 9, verses 1 to 5. I am speaking the truth in Christ. I am not lying. My conscience confirms it by the Holy Spirit. I have great sorrow and unceasing anguish in my heart, for I could wish that I myself were accursed and cut off from Christ for the sake of my own people, my kindred according to the flesh. They are Israelites, and to them belong the adoption, the glory, the covenant, the giving of the law, the worship, and the promises. To them belong the patriarchs, and for them, according to the flesh, comes the Messiah, who is over all. God blessed forever. Amen. This is the word of the Lord.
Amen.
If you are able, I invite you to stand for the Gospel reading. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Hear the Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to St. Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
Now when Jesus heard this, he withdrew from them there in a boat to a deserted place by himself. But when the crowds heard it, they followed him on foot from the town. When he went ashore, he saw a great crowd, and he had compassion for them and cured their sick. When it was evening, the disciples came to him and said, "This is a deserted place, and the hour is now late. Send the crowds away that they may go into the villages and buy food for themselves." Jesus said to them, "They need not go away. You give them something to eat." And they replied, "We have nothing here but 5 loaves and 2 fish. And he said, "Bring them here to me." Then he ordered the crowds to sit down on the grass. Taking the 5 loaves and the 2 fish, he looked up to heaven and blessed and broke the loaves, and gave it to them, and gave them to the disciples. And the disciples gave them to the crowd. All ate and were filled, and they took up what was left over the broken pieces, 12 baskets full. And those who ate were about 5,000 men, besides women and children. This is the Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Christ.
And now speak in the name of the living God, who is Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Amen. Please do be seated. So, today, we meet for the first time since the lockdown. A new, different service, shorter. There is a saying that less is more, but this can seem quite at odds with our consumerist culture. Last week, the parable of the mustard seeds, if you saw the video, I spoke of how Jesus often reversed this whole idea of less being of more being more important and less being better, how he actually taught that. And again today, the feeding of the 5,000. So much done with so very little. During the lockdown, I have repeatedly spoken about the way in which Jesus repeatedly turned the world upside down, reversed the order of things, the rich becoming poor, the poor being rich, the strong weak, and the weak strong. So the concept of many people fed with very little food, as we hear in today's Gospel, follows this theme through. But at the heart of this Gospel and all those stories is a reliance on God. Before this feeding, the today in the Gospel, the feeding of the 5,000, Jesus looked up to heaven and broke the bread. He blessed the bread, and many were fed. There are various theories about how this was possible. One is that, quite simply, by seeing others sharing their food, everyone shared all that they had. But I don't think that makes it any less of a miracle, if indeed that is what happened, and I'm not saying it is what happened. Imagine a world where there is sufficient for everyone, because everyone shares what is available. And all that stemming from a really small offering in the first place. The crux of this reading for me is that if we trust in God, trust in Jesus, then so much is possible, even though we feel, or we may feel, we have so little to offer. A few years ago, I was fortunate enough to visit Calcutta, and I visited the convent of the Sisters of the Missionaries of Charity, founded by Mother Teresa. You probably don't need me to tell you about her work. But she had very little to give, yet she gave all that she had, her life, in the service of God, in service to others. And we'll never know how many thousands of people were helped out of their suffering by her work. It's amazing, isn't it? Perhaps even that is a miracle. In the Gospel reading, all they knew they had was 5 loaves and 2 fish, woefully inadequate for 5,000 people. But Jesus didn't say, "Why bother?" He said, "Bring it to me." And 5,000 were fed. How would we feel if we were told to feed so many people with so little? Yet what happened? By trusting in God, people were fed. And it's the fact that we can't see how this could happen that it's called a miracle. I wonder how often in the church we say that. We have too little money, too few people. To what degree do we hand it over to God and trust in God, trust in Jesus? I dare say that some people will be looking at today's service, shortened, with no hymns, no sharing of the peace, with masks and social distancing and sanitizing, and thinking that somehow this is inadequate. Yet, like in the feeding of the 5,000, bread will be blessed this morning, and broken, and shared. And again, we trust in God to work out his plan of salvation for us and for the world. Lockdown is lifted, at least for the present, and we meet again as God's people, trusting that he can and will do great things with the little that we have to offer him. Amen. So I invite you to stand if you're able as we affirm our faith in the words of the Creed. Let us declare our faith in God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. I believe in God, the Father Almighty, creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, his only Son, our Lord, who was conceived by the Holy Spirit, born of the Virgin Mary, suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again and ascended into heaven. He is seated at the right hand of the Father, and he will come to judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen. So in the power of the Spirit, in union with Christ, we pray to God. We sit or kneel for our prayers of intercession. pray for the unity of the church in witness and proclamation of the gospel. We pray for this church and all churches finding their way forward in this new world post-lockdown. We pray for our church leaders and all who guide us in the faith. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for the peace and stability of all peoples and the leaders of the nations. We pray for strength and wisdom in all those who guide others in these difficult times. We pray that we seek the common good of all people. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
We pray for places of work, education and leisure, and all the areas that have been adversely affected by the coronavirus, negotiating their way to a new normal. Looking to the future, may they do so in safety, with wisdom and discernment. Lord, in your mercy,
amen.
We pray, Lord, for your blessing on our homes, our friends, our family, all our relationships and those whom we love. Lord, in your mercy,
amen.
We pray for the sick and suffering, particularly for all those on our prayer list and that are known to us in person. We give thanks for all who minister to their needs. We pray for your comfort and peace to be with them. Lord, in your mercy,
amen.
We commend to God's loving care those who have died recently, those known to us, and all those known to you. Within our community, we commend to God's loving care the souls of Philip Green and Annie Miller. Asking God's peace and comfort be with those who mourn at this time. Let us commend ourselves and all for whom we pray to the mercy and the protection of God our Father. Merciful Father, accept these prayers for the sake of your Son, our Saviour Jesus Christ. Amen. Christ Jesus is our peace. He has reconciled us all to God in one body by the cross. And we meet in his name and we share his peace. The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. Father, you made the world and love your creation. You gave your Son, Jesus Christ, to be our Saviour. His dying and rising has set us free from sin and death. And so we gladly thank you, with saints and angels, praising you and saying, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of power and might, heaven and earth are full of your glory, who is in us. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord, who is in us. We praise and bless you, loving Father, through Jesus Christ our Lord. And as we obey his command, send your Holy Spirit, the broken bread and wine at door, may be for us the body and blood of your dear Son. On the night before he died, he had supper with his friends, and taking bread, he prayed. He broke the bread, gave it to them, and said, Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. When supper was ended, he took the cup of wine. Again, he prayed, he gave it to them and said, Drink this, all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, which is shed for you and for many for forgiveness of sins. Do this as often as you drink it in remembrance of me. So, Father, we remember all that Jesus did. In him we plead with confidence his sacrifice made once for all upon the cross. Bringing before you the bread of life and cup of salvation, we proclaim his death and resurrection until he comes in glory. Great is the mystery of faith. Christ has died. Christ is risen. Christ will remain. Lord of all life, help us to work together for that day when your kingdom comes and justice and mercy will be seen in all the earth. Look with favour on your people. Gather us in your loving arms and bring us with the Blessed Virgin Mary, St. Andrew, St. John the Baptist, and all the saints to feast at your table in heaven. Through Christ and with Christ and in Christ, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, for honour and glory are yours, O loving Father, forever and ever. Amen. So let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. The line is the kingdom, the power and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. We break this bread to share in the body of Christ. Though we are one, we are all one, because we all share one body. So draw near with faith, receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ, which he gave for you, and his blood which he shed for you. Eat and drink in remembrance that he died for you, and feed on him in your heart by faith with thanks. The sight people now invite you to come forward to receive communion if you wish. Please do so with your hands as far extended as possible, and I will drop the host into your hands after I stand apart once more for both of us. So please come forward as you are directed. There will be no words of administration. The body of Christ
blood of Christ was shed for all. Amen.
Thank you.
So let us pray. Strengthen for service, Lord, the hands that have taken holy things. May the ears which have heard your word be deaf to clamour and dispute. May the tongues which have sung your praise be free from deceit. May the eyes which have seen the tokens of your love shine with the light of hope. And may the bodies which have been fed with your body be refreshed with the fullness of your life.